Late summer in eastern Washington finds farmers in their fields from sunup to sundown. This is wheat growing country, and it's time to harvest crops they've spent the whole year cultivating. The goal is to get their products to market as quickly as possible. A key link in that supply chain is the Palouse River and Cooley City Short Line Railroad that's owned by the state of Washington. Slow-moving container cars transport grain from the farmlands to mainline railroads and barges destined for domestic and international markets. On August 19, 2023, that supply chain was severed when a wildfire swept through Whitman County. Among its targets was a wooden railroad trestle on the PCC system in the small town of Winona. As flames engulfed the structure, farmers from throughout the region raced to try to contain the fire and keep it from causing further destruction. Once the fire was extinguished, the reality of the situation started setting in for farmers, shippers, and businesses. Grain elevators were already filled to the brim, and more grain was being harvested every day with no trains to move it to market and no place to store it. WSDOT worked with the governor's office to have a state of emergency declared. This allowed WSDOT's Rail, Freight, and Ports Division to expedite the process to replace the bridge. The local community was skeptical, assuming the process would take many, many months, if not years. The day after the fire, the WSDOT team got to work evaluating replacement options. Within a few days, environmental site assessments were performed. Surveys and geotechnical investigations were scheduled. Emergency permitting was coordinated with Whitman County, the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife, and the Army Corps of Engineers. Following extensive discussions, the decision was made to replace the wooden bridge with a 210-foot steel and concrete trestle to provide future resiliency and durability. The WSDOT team found funding to build the new bridge by deferring other future work, anticipating that federal emergency funds might be forthcoming at a later date. WATCO, the railroad operator that leases this part of the PCC system from the state, was contracted to undertake the construction. They immediately began sourcing materials and contractors to perform the work. Kramer Construction was hired to build the bridge, and a small team headed to Winona as soon as the contracts were signed. Work began on September 11th, less than a month after the fire. Following negotiations with a nearby property owner, the team built a new road across his property to reach the construction site. Once there was access, all the debris from the fire was cleared and construction was ready to begin. The next day, a truck carrying a massive crane slowly made its way down the rural roads and was assembled on site. Meanwhile, WATCO started building the railroad tracks so they would be ready to install when the new bridge was finished. A total of 34 steel piles were driven around the creek bed at depths of up to 75 feet as the team labored to reach the bedrock needed for stability. Steel cross bracing was installed to tie the framework together, and the piles were cut to their final elevation. Much like a mega Lego assembly, prefabricated concrete bridge sections were then lifted into place on top of the steel piles. A total of 8 concrete caps and 7 deck sections were fit together to create a solid structure. Railroad tracks were then lifted onto the new bridge deck and welded into place. Ballast and surface lining were the final elements. On October 12th, less than 2 months after the wildfire, the new bridge was completed and ready for operation. Farmers, shippers, grain elevator operators, ports, elected officials, and the WSDOT team gathered to celebrate this major accomplishment. The end of the harvest season saw shipments of wheat, fertilizer, and other agriculture products once again moving on the PCC railway. What started as devastation that seemed impossible to overcome was now the cause for celebration amidst the wheat fields of eastern Washington.